Hey Gemini, it's Dana. Deep Thoughts with Dana. How the heck are ya? Hope everybody is well. Hope everybody is well. Everybody is good and life is moving along for you. This is going to be old school. I'm not going to be on camera today. I am just doing this way because quite frankly, I am not camera ready today. So we're just going to do it old school. I'm going to let the cards fly out as they will. I will timestamp this so y'all can skip the shuffling if you don't like this part of the reading. And yeah, let's just jump right into it. So spirit, source, universal energy, what is it that you have to say? Jeez, Gem, what is going on with you guys? What is going on with you guys? Your cards are just everywhere. Spirit, source, universal energy. What is it that you need Gemini to know? The collective of Gemini spirit. What is it that Gemini needs to know? What's coming towards Gemini? What does Gemini have to look out for? What does Gemini need to look forward to, spirit? What is it that you want the collective of Gemini to know? What should they look out for? What should they look forward to? Spirit, please arrange yourself in the way that you need to be seen in these cards to bring Gemini the information that they need to know to prepare themselves for whatever it is that's coming down the road. All right, let's take a pause and see what we have here. So we have the Eight of Wands, to the King of Wands, to the Seven of Swords, the Three of Wands, and the Six of Cups. Okay, to the Fool in Reverse, the Prince of Pentacles, the Wheel in the center of your reading, Justice, the Five of Wands, the Princess of Pentacles, and the Nine of Cups in reverse. Spirit, I need... Oh, I got one too many up here. My bad. Prince of Pentacles to the Nine of Cups. All right, in reverse. Spirit, I need three more. I need three more cards for Gemini. What is it that Gemini... Golly, Gemini, what is going on with y'all? All right. Got that. Spirit, is there anything else that you want to say here for Gemini? What else is it that you would like to say for Gemini, Spirit? Anything else that you would like to add for Gemini? Anything else I need to interpret and read for Gemini, Spirit? What are your messages going? Woo, did y'all see that? Going once, going twice, going three times. Anything else, Spirit? Anything else Gemini needs to know or understand? Going once. Damn it. Where should I stop, Spirit? I just don't know where to stop. Where should I stop? Oh, goodness, this is a bunch of cards. All right, I'm taking these. I'm stopping. I have to stop, Spirit. I have to stop somewhere, okay? All right, guys, let's see what is going on here for Gemini. What is happening? All right, the Eight of Wands. There's some movement, some action, energetic shift, communication to the King of Wands and the Seven of Swords. Three of Wands, having some foresight to the Six of Cups, family. Okay, so apathy to the Ace of Cups. So there's some communication coming into you from someone that was apathetic about a relationship of some sort with you in the past. And now they want the Ace of Cups. Not only do they want a new beginning in love, but they want the Ten of Cups with you as well. They want a new beginning in love. They want a harmonious, happy relationship. They have had a personal transformation. Seven of Swords, a personal transformation in regards to some kind of betrayal, deception, deceit that has happened in the past. They have some foresight and they want to build a home with you. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. What happened? What was this in the past with this person? What was this? Yeah, look, the Seven of Swords to the Seven of Swords. I shit you not. Seven of Swords to the Seven of Swords. So there was some serious something that happened between you and another person. I don't know if you are the culprit or this other person is the culprit. But there was definitely some betrayal and deception between you in the past. And now you are contemplating with the Four of Swords what the heck your next move is going to be, right? You are trying to have some foresight with the Three of Wands about a Six of Cups relationship, about reconciling your differences and reuniting with someone from your past, someone where there was a bunch of fuckery going on, a King of Wands type character. Interesting. So you're contemplating in the Four of Swords energy what it is your next move is going to be, trying to have some foresight about reuniting and reconciling with someone from your past. You see the potential for a good relationship. You see the potential for the Ten of Pentacles. And the Six of Cups in reverse tells me that either you've been stuck in the past or that you deem it to be unrealistic. I think it's unrealistic to the Four of Pentacles, right? This is somebody that's not willing to give up what they already have in order to pursue something more different or better. This is you being a little self-protective, right? Because it's kind of unrealistic for you to reunite and reconcile. You're trying to have some foresight because all there was in the past was fuckery. Page of Cups in reverse talks about creative block, emotional immaturity. Usually when there is deception and betrayal, there is some kind of association with emotional immaturity. Emotionally mature adult people don't walk around implementing fuckery all over their relationships, right? So you're kind of doubting this whole thing. Two of Pentacles comes in and talks about balancing, though, trying to catch your balance, trying to get your balance, to the Ace of Wands, because they want to manifest a new beginning. And you know what, Gemini? I think maybe you kind of do, too. The Fool in reverse, reckless, foolish, to the Nine of Cups. Whatever happened in the past probably happened quickly, and it was absolutely positively reckless and foolish energy that brought about the discrepancy between the two of you in the first place. It caused a great deal of emotional dissatisfaction, Gemini. Okay, what else can you say about the Fool in reverse here? What else can you say about the Fool in reverse? Justice, right? But now there's some justice coming into you. To the Prince of Pentacles, slow moving. This justice has been a long time coming, but boom, look at that, the Knight of Swords. Here it comes. Buckle up, baby, because there is some justice being spoon-fed to you right here, Gemini. Spoon-fed. Wow, the Wheel in the center of your reading, a turning point in your destiny, a turning point in this situation, to justice, a turning point that brings in a great deal of honesty, fairness, and truth. The High Priestess in your intuition, in your subconscious mind, in your heart of hearts, in your soul of souls. The Wheel of Fortune in reverse. You want this cycle to break between the two of you. You do. This is what you want, Gemini. Whoever it is I'm connecting to. It's a general reading, right? I mean, general readings are like, it's like the horoscope you read in Cosmo. I mean, really? Come on. So the Wheel of Fortune Yep, look, the Chariot, you're going to take some action. You are going to take some action, and this is a turning point in your destiny because there's been justice brought to you from this King of Wands right here, who's in the upright, because now they got their shit together. This King of Wands in reverse is the same King of Wands, this egocentric, self-centered person who is the root of all of this deception, who is bringing justice to the situation with his personal, it's a king, right? With his personal transformation and his actions towards you. It does not have to be him or her, okay? There is no vagina or penis in spiritual energy. So just take that out of your mind. If you're stuck on the fact that I say him and her based on what is being projected in the pictures, you are a mental midget, okay? Get over the penis and the vagina aspect of things, okay? I am a woman, very, very much a woman, and I come up as the King of Wands in almost every one of my readings because I am a badass. So take it out and just open your mind a little. So this King of Wands in reverse, who is the root of all of the fuckery that's happening here, this King of Wands in reverse is bringing justice to the situation with their communication. Five of Wands, is this an increased focus on goal, or is this an avoidance of responsibility? It is an avoidance of responsibility because of the Six of Swords, a regretful but necessary transition to the Princess of Pentacles, where there was no manifestation happening in the past, to the Nine of Cups in reverse, more emotional dissatisfaction. So this King of Wands in reverse has avoided the responsibility of bringing justice to the situation, of communicating in the situation, but now they are, right? Now they are. The Six of Pentacles says they want to give and receive. The Emperor says that they're coming with straight up integrity, straight up daddy, right? Which is a little weird. I mean, that's a little weird, the whole daddy energy thing. I don't know. I don't want a daddy. I want an equal counterpart. But whatever, the Emperor is a boss, biatch, male or female, does not matter. They have authority. They have structure in their life. They're leaders. They're initiators. This card is representing that this King of Wands up here, who used to be a dick, is now coming forward with integrity and seriousness and intention to the Tower in reverse because of a personal transformation. The Hierophant in reverse, they have changed the way that they believe about something. Seven of Cups in reverse, illusion, diversionary tactics, let's see. Illusion, diversionary tactics, Princess of Swords in reverse, talking about all talk, no action, undelivered promises, illusion, temptation, diversionary tactics, making a decision. Yeah, okay, so they have changed their way that they think about something. To the Princess of Swords in reverse, they're all talk, no action, undelivered promises from the past. No, they want to create now. They want to sincerely, with the Emperor, sincerely bring you a message of creation to the Two of Wands, because as they look into the future, King of Swords in reverse, they don't want to be mad at you. They don't want to fight with you. The Princess of Wands in reverse, they don't want to fight with you, and they don't want any more of these setbacks to the Ten of Cups, to the new beginning in love, to the new beginning with the Ace of Wands, to the Wheel, to justice, to the whole thing. They don't want any more setbacks. They want to shift into stability, structure, foundation, harmony, relationship, commitment. The Devil. This represents their toxicity from the past. This Seven of Swords, clarifying the Seven of Swords, that's what this Devil represents, right? To the Two of Swords, this is you at a crossroads, totally at a crossroads to the Queen of Wands in reverse, because this King of Wands could not feed you in the past. They were not meeting your needs, and your fire was not being flamed. Your fire was not being flamed. Your fire was not being fanned, right? And this Queen of Wands in reverse represents this King of Wands over here not being able to meet your needs because of the betrayal and the deception. But now they've had a personal transformation, and they're approaching you as the Emperor. And I promise you, Gem, the Emperor can meet your needs for schnizzle. The Five of Pentacles in reverse. This person caused a lot of spiritual poverty for you. A lot of spiritual poverty. To the King of Pentacles. This King of Pentacles is representing you, Gemini. You pulling yourself together. You having security, control, and power in your life. Worldly success, long-term goals. This is you being represented by the King of Pentacles as being strong now, right? Because back here with the Queen of Wands in reverse, you were kind of depending on this person to feed you and keep you alive. You know, not literally, maybe literally. But now you're good. You're good, you're good, you're good. See, to the Ten of Swords, after this breakup, after this ending, after this crisis, you came out of this and you're feeling really good about yourself, Gemini. Really good about yourself. And the Ace of Swords comes in and says, truth has been spoken to you. There has been a breakthrough, a victorious breakthrough in a situation that has left you feeling less than, but now you're good with the King of Pentacles, right? Now you're good after this whole situation, after this crisis and betrayal with the Ten of Wands. You did emerge, and you emerged not just okay, you emerged powerful, because I do believe the Ace of Swords means that you learned something about yourself. You learned something about your self-worth through this situation. Knight of Pentacles comes in and talks about slow-moving energy, talks about looking into the future, right? So for a good long minute, you were stuck in some spiritual poverty. You were stuck in feelings of loss, regret, despair, and disappointment. And now this person wants teamwork and collaboration. What else? What else, Spirit? What else? What else? Yep, look, and a communication and an energetic shift. And you want it too. You want it too, Gemini. You do. You want it too. The Nine of Swords represents your anxiety in the situation, because what they did to you hurt you in a bad, bad way. But you are not going to pass up on an opportunity for change with the Five of Swords. And whoever it is I'm connecting with, you want to make a decision with the Judgment card. A decision to deal with your repressed emotions about a lost opportunity. You have reevaluated the way that you believe about yourself, about what happened, about this whole shit show right here. You have reevaluated, and you're coming out on the other side with a new perspective about your belief system in the situation. You have a lot of strength. You are strong, strong, strong. To the Hanged Man, this is you pausing, surrendering, coming out on the other side with a new perspective. To the Lovers card, that whoever it is that I'm engaging here does want to engage with this person. This person, this Gemini that I'm talking about right here, does want to engage, and you've waited for this for a long time, and it's finally here, Gemini. That is your reading. I do hope that you enjoyed it. Again, right, this is a general reading. Don't hold on to false hope. If this is something that's happening in your life and you are just hoping and praying that this is your reading, I urge you from the bottom of my heart, have your cards read so you don't go 2 months, 3 months, 6 months 8 months into the future, holding on to the false hope that this is going to happen for you and it actually not be your story. Okay? Don't waste your time holding on to false hope. There you go, Gemini. Enjoy. Namaste.